We're gonna start with our feet together, and we're just gonna warm up our feet today. Because one thing I notice is my poor feet work really hard, and I don't love my feet. I don't take care of my feet at all, except for an occasional pedicure. So we're actually gonna work on our feet. We're gonna peel all of our 10 toes up off the mat. So your feet are gonna, when you look down, you're gonna see veins, you're gonna see tendons, everything's kinda working here. Then you're gonna spread out your toes as much as you can before you put your feet down. So there should be space between all 10 toes. Some of them might be stubborn. We're gonna try it once more. Pick up all 10 toes, spread them out wide, really work the baby toes, and then press them down on the mat. Good. I'm gonna show you from the side. We're just gonna peel one foot off the floor and really push into the mat. So I'm on my tippy toe, and then I'm gonna press the whole sole into the mat, and then come to the other side, press right up onto the tippy toe, and then bring it down. So this is really good if you wear bad shoes. If you're squeezing your feet into those flats, don't do it. It's so bad for you. Press the foot down, and then press up onto that tippy toe, really spreading out the toes, and then down. Good, we're gonna do some circles with our knees, getting our synovial fluid and our knees moving, especially if you've been really inactive today, just circling around. And then change directions, round and round. Good, and notice if you get any sticky spots. There's a spot that might feel a little crunchy. Good, from here, come to stand up nice and tall. Let's peel all 10 toes up off of the ground again. Spread them on the mat, create some space. And inhale, we'll lift the arms up over the head. Palms parallel to one another. And then hinging from the waist, if you have tight quad or tight hamstrings, I should say, then keep a little bend in your knees. You should always have a micro bend anyways. And then head in line with your spine. We're just saying good evening to our hamstrings. Let them wake up. And then we're gonna bring those hands behind our backs. Interlace the fingers. If this feels like too much for your shoulders to contract here and to squeeze your shoulder blades together, then you can always clasp your elbows behind your back instead. So you choose, but we're gonna reach those arms up over, and now I'm gonna dive a little deeper, letting my head fall down towards my knees. And I want you to start to take some deep breaths. Let go of your day. Let go of what you have to do for the rest of the week. And then notice if you have tension in your spine, in your cervical spine, that's your neck. And I want you to let it go. So maybe your chin can come to your chest a little bit more.